Hi, I'm Jim Hornthal, and I'm here to talk about genomes because it's not about biology anymore. I was at Zeitgeist about 5 years ago, and Sergey was saying that doing search is hard. The only thing harder than search is discovery because you don't know what you're looking for. But the question is, who are you going to trust? So if you're looking to find a clean bathroom, then the crowds might help you with sit or squat. If you're looking to find a bar or a club, you might want to rely on your friends because they know what you like. But if it's life-threatening or if it's going to take a lot of your money or your time, we think there's an important role for experts. So we all know about the Human Genome Project that started this whole process. Massive amount of data that needed to be organized, required a good ontology and a taxonomy from which very complex algorithms could then extract meaningful insight. An example of this is a company called Genomic Health. Genomic Health realized that with node negative estrogen positive breast cancer, they could take advantage of the 25,000 genes, the SNPs that we learned from them, the algorithms they could create, and be useful. If you look at the reality of taking a biopsy, those slides stay around forever. Genomic Health took 10 years worth of slides. They knew the outcomes of women, and guess what? Recurrence based on chemo is not based on the age of the patient, the size of the tumor, or the growth. It was based on 21 genes that expressed the probability of recurrence with an R-square of 0.99. Now they can use that science. Look at what Tim Westergen and the team have done at Pandora. 750,000 songs have been deconstructed by musicologists into 400 elements. Many of us don't have the vocabulary to describe tempo, key, tempor, but with algorithms, you can find songs you like. I like Raul Madon. I go to the site, and it says, congratulations, you like Raul Madon. You may also like these other artists and musicians who have a similar approach to their music. Following one trend leads to another, leads to some insight. The Yenta genome, how hard is it to find someone like you? There are companies that look at life and love style, values and ideals. Romantic match, not an easy process. One particular company called Perfect Match has a group of sociologists and scientists that have broken it into 50 unique aspects. They look at your values, your education, your desire for cleanliness, your eco-awareness, and they start recommending people. So I created a profile for Zeitgeist, and Zeitgeist now has recommendations for people that would be perfect match for Zeitgeist. Leisure travel, Vacation Genome Project takes a look at activities and interests, your time of year when you're going, the budget you want to spend, and then can recommend destinations. 72 experts that have written 650 guidebooks have indexed 2,000 destinations around the world. When you go to the site and you pick the ones that are relevant to you, one of 560 quadrillion unique combinations, a number bigger than the federal deficit, you put them in your order of preference, where you're going from, when you're going to go, what you want to spend, and voila, a map of the world appears that is your vacation genome. Every page on that map doesn't stop with the place. There's 500,000 links and feeds that have been curated to make it relevant to you and your interests. You go to one of those pages, it's also got the deals that are best suited for the time of year you're going, the reason you're going, who's going, adults and kids. It's a chance for destination discovery. Again, experts leading time, health, finance. So where do these lessons take us? The idea of thinking about genomes beyond biology is helping move from knowledge to wisdom, right? Which doctor is best to treat me? Who's treated patients similar to me with good outcomes? Clinical trials. There's a great site called breastcancertrials.org. 98% of women eligible for breast cancer trials do not go into them because they don't know about them. Will I Am spoke earlier. This is genius. He's reversed engineered the genome. He knows the beat. He knows the key. He knows the instrumentation that's popular. The result of the hit song, I Got a Feeling, was Will's intuitively reverse engineering the genome to create something in the way. Where else can you be predictive? Okay, I know the destination match. I understand that. I can figure out what a deal would be for me. Which travel agent's best suited to me? What travel agent likes what I like? Not someone from Milwaukee that likes beer, bowling, and bratwurst, but someone that has a similar group of kids has been to where I've been. There are genomes everywhere. There's a film genome project. There's art genome. Believe it or not, there's a beer genome. I don't know how that works. There's a finance genome as well, because managing your assets, really tough to do. Experts can help. They can look for nodalities and modalities. What do you need for future genomes? You need experts. There are 400 in this room. You need massive data. Google helps us find it, but you got to organize it. What's the ontology? What's the taxonomy? Where is that pattern recognition going to come from, if not from people like you in the room? Thinking about those algorithms will help you take data, transform it into information. That's the first step to knowledge, but ultimately, we're looking for wisdom. What does that education genome look like that they were talking about earlier? Where can we find those patterns to make it more likely that people avoid the gangs and get into it? How can you turn finding a needle in a haystack into finding a haystack of needles? Thank you.